Good morning, class. My name is Nanette Ramirez, and I'll be your moderator for this morning's session. Welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school, and it is not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a nonprofit, non-denominational, religious, and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of his eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio in the year of 1931. We were incorporated in the state of California in 1958. Since then, we've established various branch schools throughout the United States and various parts of the world. The Ontario branch was established in May of 1988. In this school, we use the true, correct, and original name and title of the Father, the Word or Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title of the Word or Son is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted by God. The name of the Holy Spirit manifested in or out of a physical body is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted by Jesus Christ. Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are Lords many and Gods many, but we now know that each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. That means Elohim is the title that our Creator chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. The minor investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any characters or letters in their alphabet that would produce the sound that is made by the letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings of the true and original name of our Father and His Son. Christ is a title, just like Lord and God. Yahweh is pure spirit. And in this state, he is incomprehensible and inscrutable. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh in his pure spirit state, symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. We have drawn this cloud all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart is within the cloud. In like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and took on form right within himself as Elohim. This is the Word, our Son. A super incorporeal being that is having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. This form could only be seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this self same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now there is only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. The simple yet intelligent question that we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time that he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, he called Moses atop of Mount Sinai and showed him the tabernacle pattern in a vision. Yahweh instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court roundabout. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. In this school, we show proof that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. Our 10 primary constitutional objectives and aims of this institute are, first, to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and actually exists. Second, to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of race or nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third, to investigate the unexplained spirit law or so-called law of nature and powers latent in man. Fourth, to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religions, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Fifth, to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Sixth, to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. Seventh, to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. Eighth, to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith, which was once delivered to the sons or children of Yahweh. Ninth, to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved, saving the name of Yahshua the Messiah. Tenth, to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah, with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth. This morning, we'll have a prayer by Dr. Samuel Salas. And after the prayer, we have a selection of music. Our scripture lesson will be Jude, the first chapter, and that'll be read by Dr. Eunice Reiser.
Good morning, class. It's a time of prayer. Thank you, Almighty Yahweh, for all the things you give us daily basis. And also thank you for sending the Holy Spirit to teach us through the vessels of the founder, Henry Cliff Kinley, Robert Harris, Dennis Dulari, Mary Gross, and Dr. Gross, which we are so happy to have the instruction from them. But we know, we are aware, you are the one. And keep blessing us when we are in this physical world and we know our destination. And thank you, everything you give us. I say all those things in your only son's name, Yahshua the Messiah. Let us all say hallelujah.
Oh, you go down in a place. Good morning, class. I'll be reading Jude, the first chapter, the only chapter of Jude, page 323. And I'll be reading out of the Holy Name Bible containing the Holy Name version of the Old and New Testament, critically compare with ancient authorities and various manuscripts, revised by the late A.B. Trainum, Scripture Research Association, Incorporated. Jude 1. Judah, the servant of Yahshua the Messiah, and the brother of James, to them that are sanctified by Yahweh the Father, and preserved in Yahshua the Messiah, and called, mercy unto you, and peace and love be multiplied. Beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the coming salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you, and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith which was once for all delivered unto the sons. For there are certain men crept in unawares, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, wicked men, turning the grace of our Elohim into lasciviousness, and denying the only Elohim and our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah. I will therefore put you in remembrance, though ye once knew this, how that Yahweh, having saved the people out of the land of Egypt, afterwards destroyed them that believed not. And the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, he has reserved in everlasting chains under darkness until the judgment of the great day. Even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them in like manner, given themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh, are set forth for an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. Likewise, also, these filthy dreamers defile the flesh, despise dominion, and speak evil of dignities. Yet Michael, the archangel, when contended with the adversary concerning the body of Moses, durst not bring against him a railing accusation, but said, Yahweh rebuke thee. But these speak evil of those things which they know not, but what they know naturally as brute beasts, in those things they corrupt themselves. Woe unto them, for they have gone in the way of Cain, and ran greedily after the heir of Balaam for reward, and perish in the gainsaying of Korah. These are spots in your love feasts, which they feast with you, feeding themselves without fear. Clouds they are without water, carried about by winds. Trees which fruit withered, without fruit, twice dead, plucked up by the roots. Raging waves of the sea, foaming out their own shame. Wandering stars, to whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. And Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, Yahweh cometh with 10,000 of his sons to execute judgment upon all and to convince all that are wicked among them of all their wicked deeds, which they have wickedly committed, and of all their hard speeches, which wicked sinners have spoken against them. These are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lust, and their mouths speaketh great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. But, beloved, remember ye the words which was spoken before of the apostle of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who shall walk after their own wicked lusts. These be they who separate themselves, sensual, having not the Spirit. But ye, beloved, building up yourselves on your own holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of Yahweh, looking for the mercy of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah, unto eternal life. Some refuse while they dispute with you, but others save by arousing their fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating every trace of sinful lust. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua, the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all time and now and ever. I have read Jude, the first chapter. Let us all say hallelujah.
So good morning again, class. Before I call the first speaker, I'd like to welcome back a visitor, Mr. Talon Love. So our first speaker this morning, will be our treasurer, Dr. Eunice Reiser.
Good morning, class. It's an honor and a privilege that Yahweh has awakened me this morning to be here with the frame of mind of wanting to be here and knowing this is the only place of understanding, of strength, of life, you know, that I can come to learn more about his purpose, pattern, and plan. And the moderator, I was once told, and I can actually agree, that if we all understood the moderation and the aims, you know, we can go. And it does so much what our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, what Yahweh gave him a divine vision and revelation, and what he responded to Yahweh when asked, you know, what are you going to do with what I've given you? And the final answer was to teach his people. And from that point, from the vision and revelation, these charts that we have here is from the vision and revelation that Yahweh gave to Dr. Kinley. And I know it's hard for some people to wrap their heads around that God really, Yahweh showed himself to a man in a physical body. But if one knew the scriptures, then they would see and know that Yahweh did not, the Creator did not leave his creation to be told, to be taught, you know, that we would know just for a man to tell it. Yahweh himself manifested himself in the flesh. We, to understand that which I didn't know, I first had to understand that the true name is Yahweh. And Yahweh is masculine and feminine. In Hebrew, it was only consonants, which was YHWH. But so that we could understand it, we had to have vows. So with Yahweh being masculine and Way is being feminine, Yahweh demonstrated it in his creation because he created man, Adam. Now, Adam has a vowel two times in his name, which is A. So, if we have YHWH, the first man is Adam. And the first woman, Eve, was taken out of Adam. Is Eve. So simply, in order to make it for us, Yahweh chose Adam or A to show the masculinity of himself and E for the feminine woman. And everything we can look and see, everything after the name of Yahweh is masculine and feminine. Whether or not we want to talk about man, we want to talk about beasts, talk about birds. Even when Noah, when Yahweh told Noah to take, you know, the two and put them in the ark because he was going to flood the earth. But also to do that, he started another. So he needed the male and female to do the reproduction to carry on his purpose. So we have Adam and we have Eve. Yahweh's name is he who causes everything to exist. And Yahweh, knowing that we could not understand that, see that, because when you try to think of Yahweh is pure spirit, like the moderator said. So if Yahweh is pure spirit, you know, man's mind cannot even conceive of that. Yahweh, knowing that, you know, took on a shape and form as Elohim. This is the title he chose. And in this title, you know, it shows things of the tabernacle. It shows things of the tribe. Yahweh does not do anything just to say everything has a meaning, which is pointing towards something in his purpose that he's already planned. Elohim. We have the enzymes that's around the 12 tribes of in the wilderness. One is the eagle, the lion, the oxen, and the man. So Elohim is not just a title as we look at it. It is describing other things or something else that he has set forth in his purpose. Now, Elohim can be seen in divine vision and revelation with an understanding it is he that will appear, that you will see. These are divine attributes. Yahweh is the source, and from the source, he took on this shape and form of a man. Right within, this is not anything different. It's spirit in a shape and form. This is still Yahweh in a shape and form. These attributes, this is Elohim. And to go it or the word or son, because when we go into the scriptures, we're going to, like if we got John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word. This is what we can look at, Yahweh in a shape and form that John is talking about in John. This is the Word or Son. Now, Yahweh knowing that even this with man's mind, he gave man a sufficient amount of intelligence. But we also have our little opposition that wants to present ourselves to be more. So Yahweh knowing, he manifested the Word or Son, which is himself, Yahshua, manifested, he manifested in the flesh. This is the Holy Spirit. Yahweh Elohim manifested in the flesh. Yah, and he said in the scripture, I come in my Father's name. Now, when he came, we can easily recognize its simplicity. His name is Yahshua, and his Father's name is Yahweh. He does bear his Father's name. Yahshua is Yahweh is salvation. This is what we can obtain to in that where we are now to understand in a physical manifestation, just like Romans 1:19 and 20. That which may be known of Yahweh is manifested in the flesh. So Yahweh stepped into his own creation. In fact, this whole creation from first day all the way through everything, he came from him. He created the whole universe. He created man. What Elohim, in order for us to perceive and understand him in the flesh, well, we have no questions, no doubt, because we're able to witness it ourselves. He manifested himself in a physical body. Not only did he come, as the world knows, as Jesus Christ, further down the road, but Yahweh manifested right off the bat with Adam, first man. He manifested through all these men. And when he put the job, after giving the promise to Abraham, and the main story that we are given is the story about Moses delivering the children up out of Egypt into the wilderness. It shows forth not just the story, but the main, according to this chart, Elohim, the archetype, original pattern of the universe. He chose Moses and told Moses to build this pattern. This pattern, which is a court roundabout, holy place, most holy place, three compartments but one tabernacle. This pattern fits everything and according to the function and structure. We have human body. Our body fits this tabernacle, not just only the three compartments, but the vessels in it just as well. He gave this pattern the altar of sin sacrifice, the brazen laver, the holy anointing oil. There's the door. In fact, there is seven steps to this tabernacle. Now, we've come to learn that seven denotes perfection. And it is a perfect work with this tabernacle, just as Yahweh causes our physical body to perfectly work. But there's, as this tabernacle stood in the wilderness and was broken down and put back up, eventually it does like our human body. It wears out. If you, with the rain and whatever weather, it gets tethered. So whatever we do to our bodies that is not accordingly, we get warped, we get tattered, and it stops functioning also. Now, there's 9 vessels also in the tabernacle. These 9 vessels is likened to our 9 divine attributes. You cannot see these 9 divine attributes, but take something physical to understand that which you cannot see. And with Moses was the first person to know the name of the Creator. And we can get that over in Exodus, to where Moses was the only one who knew. They knew many gods. They knew many names. And Yahweh was very specific in showing Moses and telling Moses what his name was and giving him a job to do. So,
do you want me to start where he's at the burning bush or a little bit further down?
Just start. Okay. Yeah.
Stay on the name.
Yeah.
Moses asked for a name.
Okay, that's 13. So Exodus 3:13. And Moses said unto Elohim, Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel and shall say unto them, The Elohim of your fathers hath sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, What is his name? What shall I say unto them?
Now that seems to be a real logical question, because these people knew of all kinds of frog gods, rain gods, water gods, you know, you name it, it was a god unto them. Yahweh rained down 10 devastating plagues, and those plagues hit them according to the gods that they worship. And they didn't, you know, there was nothing that they could do about it. But Yahweh did this, will show them that your God is nothing to be compared to what he has done. If he was, he would have been able to do something. But Yahweh performed those plagues to knock down their idol, their God. Go ahead. I lost my thought.
And Elohim said unto Moses, Ea Asher Ea. And he said, Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I will be hath sent me unto you. And Elohim said moreover unto Moses, Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, Yahweh, the Elohim of your fathers, the Elohim of Abraham, the Elohim of Isaac, and the Elohim of Jacob, hath sent me unto you. This is my name forever, and this is my memorial unto all generations.
Now, this is exactly what I missed growing up, and a whole lot of people missed growing up, and a whole lot of people miss now. Just that section of the scripture alone. I can understand why we didn't know, because if you don't have the name right, then you ain't gonna have anything right. It's like when you get the name right, it is totally clear. He said, This is my name, Yahweh. If you know his name, Elohim, Yahshua, this is my name forever. It does, but that is, the issue is, they don't know the name. And it was set up perfectly that they wouldn't. It is his story. But for us, the sons, that he has given us this pattern and given us a knowledge of how to go about learning his name, what his name means. All of that, like Aaron was saying the other night, he say little nuggets. Those little nuggets are some very expensive jewels. Because I go back to think of when I did not know any of this, didn't know, have a clue. And now I'm coming to appreciate, you know, when it says a branch. Well, you know, my mind now is like, let me go check out what is a branch. A branch, according to how Yahweh has set up in the scriptures here, it does not mean the same thing everywhere. You know, like Yahshua, I mean, it's not talking about a tree. Also, too, when he healed the blind man and he asked the blind man, what do he see? He said, I see men walking as trees. So we can't take the book literally, but it takes Yahweh giving you some understanding that he does speak in parables. But we must learn the parables. I am thankful that he woke me up to learn, to listen. Pay attention. This is serious life-giving information. It will awake you to the spirit that's already in you. That we didn't have, I didn't have, not have a clue. When he say, go to the law, he said, what is it? If they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light, no understanding. Yahshua said, I am the light. So if it's not according, so that's what we can use for that. What aim is that? To help to discern and avoid, because we got all kinds of people that are out and they are sounding good. Great swelling words. But they don't know about the law and they don't know how to go and show you that Yahshua instituted water baptism over here. And it was, what did he tell John? Over here, suffer it to be so, for it becometh us to fulfill. It's not about instituting anything. All of it has been put to an end. That is being made free from the law of that sin and death that it has perpetrated all the way from these children, all the way down even unto now, to believe that we got to keep some type of law. The law that we are going to keep, having the truth and understanding the purpose and plan of Yahweh as he, whatever part that he has given unto us. That is our law, and we will walk in that way. It ain't no try. It's in you already. And it's just those old demons, if I can put it that way. Because we do, Yahweh made, Samuel and I was talking about this this morning. Yahweh have a mystery of righteousness and a mystery of iniquity. And I think it's really beautiful. There is nothing wrong with this boy. He does his job. Yahweh say, I made him perfectly. He is set. I set him so. So if there's a problem in accepting his work, that's Yahweh's will. He's more obedient than me. Because he's doing exactly. We do not, hey, we don't like it. It don't seem. But then, too, when you just stop and look at it, all hell is breaking loose everywhere. Look, there's killings all kinds of ways. Politicians up there lying like crazy. You know, just people, I mean, dying. And everybody is just looking at it like, oh, wow. Gas prices is through the roof. Well, that should just let you know. I mean, just naturally, so who want to live in something like this? I mean, everything is going downhill all the way. You better have something to look at that is life-sustaining, peace of mind. This teaching is the only thing, the only weapon that we have, because Buddy Boy will take you down to degradation. Give it a thought. That's his job. And will come in sheep clothing too. It's a lot, but Yahweh has given us such weaponry to recognize those things. You know, I mean, I can fool myself real good. I don't need nobody else's devil. I can do it, you know what? Because I am that creation. Yahweh has set, you know? So yes, we are gonna do that. I'm not here for my goodwill. I didn't ask to come here. Yahweh's will was given. I'm coming to an understanding. I ain't doing nothing. Yahweh's will is being done whether or not I like it or not. The thing that is lovely about it is when I accept, let your will be done. Father, I don't know. I don't know how this works. I don't know whether or not it is going to work. What do you want me to do? I conversate with Yahweh all the time because I don't know, and I'm not going to act like I know. I'm talking about on everyday, daily basis. I go out there in my garden. I saw the beautiful thing. I have some tomatoes that they are growing like, woo, they are nice. And I got some green beans growing nice. But I got some collard greens. They look like their growth has been stunt. But, you know, it's beautiful to me how Yahweh choked and planted at the same time. There's some that's going to grow fast and beautiful and some that is just going to take a while. But it's still all Yahweh. You know, I watch the birds and the little bees pollinate on there. How do they know? How do they? They're doing their job. We need them. We need that. You know, it's beautiful. And Yahweh has given us in Ontario some love that man, you can't even draw it. Because we love this gospel. We love our husband man. We will teach. We will do whatever it takes. We want to keep everything open. We want. And as Yahweh's will, it is happening. We are not working up on it. I thank Yahweh for all of you. Because it's another opportunity that we are being given to learn the function of the body, how well it functions without our help. and that we praise Yahweh anyway. And the people that are out there that don't know, they should be in here learning, because they are praising Yahweh too, and they don't know it. Yahweh, heal, soul. They're praising Yahweh already and don't realize it. But yet you got a problem with the name. But you ain't got no problem with your mom and daddy's name. You ain't got a problem with your name attached. You may not like your daddy, but you still attached to his name. You're denying your own self. And sometimes it's scary to see people that do have or have heard, and they just turn it to naught. Like, I got it, or they don't realize that if I say, look, I understand and I can finish what you're trying to convince me of in the book. I thought of it too. I thought God was out there too. You know, I've had some of those experiences too. But that ain't the truth. So what did you get? What did it tell you about your creator? I've heard of the tabernacle. What did you hear? Oh, they just talked about the tabernacle. Did they tell you about how many vessels in there? Did they tell you it fits? It's just like your body? No. Well, there's more to understanding and knowing about your creator than what you say you already know. No, you don't. That is hard to get people to see. You don't know. If you have not, Yahweh has not shown you about himself, you don't know. And this is not from any great studying. It's not from any great on your knees praying. I'm not saying not to pray. Oh, yeah, you pray. Because I always do. I say, look, if Yahweh's will tomorrow, if Yahweh's will when I get there, you know, this and this, I don't know. I'm not one to say, you know, yes. Tomorrow, that I know tomorrow is coming. No, I don't. But it is Yahweh's will, and he's given us so much history. The pattern fits these stories. I greatly appreciate it, Will, saying, you know, be familiar with the stories at least. And there's more that I would like to get into, as Yahweh's will be, about the prophets. Because everything that this man you hear in the New Testament, you can find it somewhere in the Old, or from what Moses wrote all the way to Malachi. And you will find that Joshua, that was Moses' minister, Joshua was Yahweh manifested in the flesh. Moses really didn't know. This man was the one that called him up. Yahweh manifested in a physical body in order to see he is manifested in you. We got scripture, and these scriptures, look, they're good. And they're good for corrections, for reproof, but they are good. He tells us what he's saying in the book. Where were we? In Jude, I think it was in Galatians, maybe, that I was reading. But, you know, we are the temple. We are Yahweh's. Where Yahweh abide. He's not out there. Your attributes, who you are. That's within you already. We are to come into that consciousness. Joe used to say, you're already who you're looking for. And Dr. Kinley, he was no exception to say, I am Yahweh. And so are you. The difference is just like Adam. When Adam was up here in the garden, they were at perfect peace. They were good. What happened with them with the when Eve partook of the lie and they were driven out? It wasn't really, we talking about a physical, driven out. They were driven out up here in their consciousness. That's where we lost it. When we came out of the womb, we started coming on down to learn and understand how we getting back to where we originally came from. That's why we are here. Why Yahweh so loved us that he gave us this road map that we can know. When we came out of that womb, we came out, you can say, dead on arrival, because we start marching towards a physical freaking death. Now you tell me what human being wants to just be walking and say, well, I'm going to my death. How much fun and happy life can you have? You ain't got none. But you can have a happy life if you know you are going back from whence you came, pure spirit. You are this beauty. You are the love. You have that strength. All those adversities out there, choose when one confronts, hey, Yahweh, you got this. Either way you decide, I'm with you. And believe me, you will be surprised and amazed at the things that Yahweh will do. I do not underestimate the power of Yahweh. I do not. And I just got a mediocre, little simple life. And every little simple thing is good to me. It's important. I look at it. I thank Yahweh for it. You know? I don't know where I went. But anyway, Yahweh is awesome. He's not above the sun, moon, and stars. He's given us the intelligence and knowledge. We go through regular school, and this is what we do in regular school. We do here. It's not a church. You know, it's a school of the highest learning. You will not learn this in regular school, but this will help you in regular school. It's a pattern. And Yahweh has set it all for us. This is our map. This builds our confidence and assurance. When we see it does line up. He did die. He was buried and he resurrected. And it was amazing to find out that Pentecost, when he poured out his spirit, Pentecost is still going on. It's still time that someone can come in here and listen. And Yahweh be amazed that he allow you to catch just a little bit of something. You know, it doesn't, just a little bit. It doesn't matter, because within you, you know it's the truth. And the only way you could get it is that spirit that gave it to you is in you. That is as simple as it works. Don't let your adversary come along and tell you anything other. That's the fight. That's to keep your head up. You got too much. must be time for me to sit on. But I thank my Heavenly Father. I really do. Talking about love, a relationship, naturally so. The man and the woman, they communicate. They talk to each other. They make each other laugh. You know, they entertain each other. Yahshua does the same thing to me. I guess that's why I if I ain't got a man, I had the opportunity to have one. But, you know, when I couldn't meet that same frame of mind and I knew what was important to me, they didn't. Then I'm sorry. I had to give it up. I tried. But you know what? It kicked my butt, too. But it was good because I saw my flesh. I saw what I, not Yahweh, hey. And it wasn't no two different places either. I'm a demon, man. You know, it's sad. Carnal mind is ugly. Ugly will make you act ugly. And it's a blessing. So I'm satisfied with my man. You know, and even if Yahweh gave me a physical one, he will, hey, love him too. Love him too. We will both be loving our man. Because there's no male and female, bond or free. Spirit has no color. It ain't got no gender like that. It doesn't. It will make you free. Free indeed. And with that, I thank Yahshua for allowing me to be here. And as always, or in my own mind, I don't have nothing to say. I don't know what to say. But I do. It's just love. It is. And that covers a whole big scope. And, you know, there's things about my own self that I'm recognizing, and it's like, I didn't know. But that's the spirit. You know, get to know what's in you. What's in you. And it is it's a pleasure. And it's much easier to deal with folks that is in opposition of you. It is easier. Because you can't, I don't waste my time in arguing. I know who Yahshua is, where he is. My love, I can only speak it to you. I can show you as plainly as possible. You can choose to go the way that you want to. I'm not going to argue. I'll say, okay. And 9 times out of 10, when I tell that person, okay, well, they want to come back. Like, why did you give up so easy? Because, see, I used to argue. My mom said, girl, you should be a lawyer because you'll argue with a fence post. When I was little. And I see the change. I'm not arguing if I, hey, Yahshua, why? Why? He's the truth. I know they don't know. I know they don't know. But when things really come down, you know, we're not dealing with having sympathy to those that know not Yahweh. Because Yahweh has written in all, every man is a witness. So there's no excuse not to know Yahweh. None. So there will come a time, oh, well, Oh, well, you bus in the late. What can I say? You know, it's not my will, it's y'all's will. That's his choosing, you know, and I'm just hope and pray that I continue. Y'all would keep me and just elevate my consciousness to going home. Be who he made me to be, not an image, an idea. Who he made me to be, that I am pleasing to him. I don't care about man, but to him. I have to live in him. So with that, y'all, I thank you for the time. And I thank Yahshua for giving us all the strength, giving me the strength and the words. If anybody got anything out of what I've said, all praises go to Yahshua. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Dr. Eunice Reiser. So for our next speaker, I'd like to call our dean, Dr. Marlon Love.
Good afternoon, class. It's a pleasure to be here. Happy Father Day to all you fathers, as it were. And moms, huh?
Yeah, my mom and dad.
Yeah, mom and dad, mom, both. As she said, the spirit doesn't see male or female. And therefore, we all take some part in having that XY chromosome within us, both, just as she clearly explained about this Yahweh. But the name of Yahweh, being both masculine and feminine. I really enjoyed the inspiration of the previous speaker, of the things that she expounded upon by laying a foundation and setting up an understanding that one's going to need to understand about this name. And I cross over all of these, Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua, in order to express to an individual that they're all the same spirit. There's not various spirits. As some people might say, well, Yahshua is the Holy Spirit. Let me go ahead and work on this one right quick. Grab me John 4 and 24, if you would. Some people think the Holy Spirit is like a special spirit of some sort, and you're going to be able to obtain a Holy Spirit, as though you're going to become a holy person by having a Holy Spirit of some sort. And a person who may express that this Holy Spirit is better than another spirit. You have Satan, and people deem of a bad thing that we have down here on this chart. What do we have here? Where else we got it? Well, just go ahead and show, demonstrate that this caricature of Satan, Lucifer, devil, dragon, serpent, whatever you want to call it, is negative spiritual entity is something different than this one. 4:24. But you ask me, what is Yahweh? It don't say Yahweh is a holy spirit. What does it say? For Yahweh is spirit, not a spirit, because A would indicate that there's other multiple spirits. So that's why you kick that A out that's in your book. It reads A. Read it like you're supposed to be read, just straight away.
For Elohim is a spirit.
For Elohim is a spirit. See, Elohim is a pluralistic title. It's not a name. It is a title that Yahweh gave himself. Now, they knew of Elohim's plural. That's why they associated it to a god. And they knew of Elohim. Grab me Exodus 6 and 3. Right quick. Let me show you. They understood about Elohim.
Exodus.
They understood about El. Read.
Exodus 6 and 3.
Uh-huh.
And I appeared unto Abraham.
Now look, this is Yahweh Elohim appearing to Moses and telling Moses this. Read.
Unto Isaac and unto Jacob as El Shaddai.
They appeared to them as El Shaddai, which is God the Almighty. Keep reading.
But by my name, Yahweh.
But by my name, Elohim is not a name. El Shaddai is not a name either. It is a title, just like God is a title. Because El, if you look it up in the dictionary, do your homework, El simply refers to as God. And that's why I say they knew of Elohims. They knew of El. Or of, as the English person substituted and put in God, they knew of El Shaddai. Keep reading, but by name, what?
But by my name, Yahweh, was I not known to them.
Okay.
And I have also established my covenant with them.
And he established, and this is Moses being talked to by Yahweh Elohim, that he's going to establish something with him. And what he established was this Ten Commandment law that he gave down to them in Exodus 20. The Ten Commandments essentially, or we call them the carnal ordinances. That's what they were given. And people say, well, this Yahweh or that Tetragrammaton, this Wahe, is for them Jews. It's not for us. It's for them people 2,000 years ago. We're not dealing with that God anymore or that name of Yahweh. It has nothing to do with what I believe in Jesus Christ. Well, you're going to have to look at it and understand. You're reading a Bible and you got to use the whole book. You can't use part of a book. You can't just use the so-called New Testament. And what we're expressing, that Eunice expressed, that you need the whole enchilada. You need the Old Testament and you need the New Testament in order to make rhyme nor hair of what that Bible's talking about. Now, she brought it around very beautifully. I'm trying to catch up to where she was expressing that Bible and these charts are just pictorial illustrations of what's in your Bible. Meaning, when Dr. Kinley, I'm gonna need Proverbs 29 and 7. I need it, Proverbs 29, I believe it's 29 and 7, where there's the vision. Dr. Kinley had a divine vision revelation as Eunice expressed. And what he saw is what you see here. And everything that you see here is coming from out of a book. We use a book because it's the neutral point in the situation. It's a neutral element that is around the world. The Quran is not around the world. The Jehovah's Witnesses books are not around the world. And everything that you have is drawn from out of that Bible first. And it's written in some 3,000 languages around the world. The ministers that went out and colonized groups of people and gave them that book. There's something in that book. It's the neutral element that we can learn of. Now, you don't have to be a Bible thumper. You don't have to memorize it. I'm asking for scripture right now. I don't know what verse is it. I know approximately where it's at. But it's not what and how you know the book as far as remembering it, is understanding. Because when we learn something, learn how to drive and get a license, you're authorized. Hey, when you learn how to, for me, when I learned how to operate a crane, I got certified. They can't just call any old body off the job site and go up and run the crane. You had to be certified to do what I happen to do. Now, you have a book. And I had to use books to read about how to different elements of the crane work in order for me to become efficient at it. We have a book that's universal, and we know darn well that everybody's looking into that book, and they got denominations galore. Well, I think this, and I think that. Well, why are you thinking so hard? Read.
Proverbs 29 and 18.
Proverbs 29 and 8. This is Solomon writing by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, because Solomon ain't write nothing of himself. I can go to Peter being an apostle, made and known of Yahshua the Messiah, and he telling the people, he tell us in the book, that he said that none of the prophets wrote of themselves. They all wrote by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And this is what Eunice was expressing, that she's loving within herself of knowing that. Everybody's walking around trying to wonder who and what they are. They're disenchanted. They're disconnected oftentimes. And they cry out. And all we're expressing is using a neutral book everybody's privy to and showing the real reason of why we study the book. Because we're not telling you the do's and don'ts with by the book Bible told me. So we're not singing that song down here. We're not telling you how to act with the Bible. The Bible ain't tell you how to do anything. The Bible's not about you. So if you understand that point, that'll take the pressure off of you thinking you're going to do something. And now, yeah, you doing anything. As Eunice has said, you moving by the Holy Spirit to give you breath and give you life to even say his name. Not even realize that you're breathing his name when you born as a child coming out of that mother's womb, like you say, dead on arrival, but it's alive when he cries out that name. But when you're on your deathbed and that little beeper's beeping, whoop, 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 and you're breathing, and that last thing you do, you don't, it just stuck there. You exhale is your last breath. That's that, yah, in the beginning until you get to the end when that, and you're deceased. You see, that's your period of time frame. And in that, you're saying the name of Yahweh. That's why you have this chart that symbolized on a cloud, on this chart as a cloud that goes all the way around. You're not getting outside of Yahweh no kind of way. You're going to live, move, and have your being right within Yahweh. Grab me Acts 17 and go ahead and read Proverbs right now about this vision. Read.
Proverbs 29 and 18.
Uh-huh.
Where there is no prophetic vision.
Where there's no prophetic vision. Read.
The people perish.
The people are going to perish. You're going to have to see something, realizing, not just with your eyes talking about vision, talking about perceiving the things of Yahweh. That's an understanding. Do you see? You look up here, you can't find Yahweh. I'm pointing up here, do you see? But you can't see Yahweh. You got to understand. That's why you say you got to come down and learn about this, which we have been given of the vision that Dr. Kenny had. And mind you, Yahweh always spoke to people in visions. That's why everybody got an opinion now. Yahweh talking to everybody, but you can't see them. You can't perceive them because they run around saying, why God make me do this? Or why God do that? You're asking why, but you're not seeing his purpose, his pattern. Because if he knew his purpose and pattern, you wouldn't have such a hard time at what people are doing and what people are saying. You'll be able to understand. You'll be able to read their unexpressed thoughts. That's what Joe Williams used to say. Because it's a pattern. Ain't nobody different. We all come by this tabernacle pattern. You just talked about it. This is a pattern of heavenly things. Yes, Moses saw this pattern on top of the mount within the cloud, having a vision. These 73 people, Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu, and the 70 elders, they did not see this tabernacle. They only saw the Elohim in shape and form of these attributes. These attributes go in a proper fashion. You got building blocks. We teach our kids from the very elementary of things. What's large, what's small. You got that little, I remember thinking of that little toy, and the kids try to get them to get the coordination to put the circles on the dial, and you got to put them in a sphere. You're teaching them coordination, putting it in order, because there's an order to things. A, B, C, D. Your alphabets are in order. You can't talk to someone about F, G, L, Z, Y, C. You're not going to get that. It's out of pattern. It's out of step. And so what we're saying is Elohim, or Yahweh, pure spirit, is incomprehensible. No shape or form. You can't see him. high nor hear with your five divine senses, sight, touch, sound, taste, and smell. You can't get to Yahweh like with those senses, but that's all you got to learn with are your five senses. That's how we learn anything, anybody. That's all you got. Oh, what about the sixth sense? What about the sixth sense? Nah, we're talking about take the physical to understand the spiritual. You have an imagination or a delusion with that sixth sense if it's not according to Yahweh's purpose. And yeah, you can dream up and think about anything you want to, but is it according to Yahweh's will? Because five, hey, this, as she talked about the steps, that five is in the holy place of a tabernacle. I'm using that as a specific point whereby you have to be in something in order to understand something. That's why you only have five senses. Now, this is what you're going to learn with. Outside of here, you're not learning. I'm looking up, using a pattern, and understand that five, that fifth step, you got to be inside the tabernacle. Because understand this tabernacle, put the tabernacle on the screen, please. Inside this tabernacle, this is a tabernacle within this outer court. You follow? And when you understand it, you got to go in, not just in this court roundabout. See here? This is a court roundabout. And when I say go in the tabernacle, I'm saying go into the sanctuary here, this fifth step inside of here, because this is where the priests ministered and did their work, having light that candle, having create that the four ingredients to make this incense. You know, then this is where they ate that shewbread, the 12 loaves on here. See, they weren't doing all that out in the open. Everybody got you out here, but inside, only a few were able to go inside, and that was the Levitical priesthood. Wasn't everybody running up and out of this inside of this tabernacle? They brought their sacrifices to the gate, but they weren't running in and out of here. And this was all exposed, just like your body. Hey, this is a core roundabout in your stomach, in your abdominal region. It's all exposed. That's why in your chest region you have your rib cage. That's because it's matching why this is a holy place. And in your head, your skull, cranium head force, or your cranium skull, hey, it's covered. That's what is matching up to. And when you see how this tabernacle that Moses saw in a vision, only Moses knew how to construct it. Moses had given a vision from Yahweh. That's how they created the tabernacle. And the whole world believes that there was a tabernacle. But only Moses was the one that knew how to construct it. With the help of the Holy Spirit being in who, Doc? Eliab, Bezalel, and Oliel. Those were the two others, and there were others that had the inspiration of the Holy Spirit that were in them in order to craft these furnishings just so perfectly. Just so perfectly. It took the Holy Spirit to construct that. Hey, it takes the Holy Spirit to construct the buildings that I erect, what Yahweh has put in mankind to build. But they're totally and surely removed from understanding Yahweh. They yet do great and wonderful works all around the world. But do they worship and do they understand his purpose? Because it's Yahweh that moves not only me or Eunice, it moves every jot and tittle that we see all around the world. Not just in America, I mean all around the world is the Spirit. Read Acts 17. I went down where, but let's skip back up since I talk about the whole world and catch it in the beginning, talking about where he's at on Mars Hill.
Oh, okay, 22.
Okay, this is Saul, who's been converted and has the Holy Spirit in him, well, and he's an apostle. 21. You're going to go up a little further, right?
For all the Athenians and strangers which were there spent their time and nothing else but either to tell or to hear some new thing.
That's it. That's what they were doing in the Greeks. Go on and catch it from the very beginning, and then we set it up so everybody understand what's transpiring. This is Saul at a certain location in Grecia. Read.
Now, while Saul waited for them at Athens, his spirit was stirred in him.
See, the spirit was stirred in Saul, just like that spirit Eunice said, be stirred in her to love or to hate. You see, Yahweh not all just love.
That's right.
He not all just beauty. He ugly too.
That's right.
He, everyone you see an opposite, and he controlling all of that. That's why we have our actions and conditions, but we got to put that under subjection. That's why you have that sapphire stone. When we understand, and like Eunice said, walking in the spirit of a knowledge of him, we can control those actions. But that don't mean that all of a sudden I'm righteous and pious, and I'm not going to be like they try to esteem themselves to do in the world, as far as they don't have no problems, but sure enough, there's enough things unraveling. People are, damn, I got caught. Dang, I done got caught. Oh, I done molested the little kid. Oh, I should have done that. It's too late then. Mm-hmm. It's too late then. You doing what you think you know to do. You don't have Yahweh or have no control of who and what you are. And there's come a time when things get so bad, you're not going to know where to go or what to do. Mm-hmm. And when the gospel, the vision is taken away, we just had Ezekiel. Oh, it's too much. Just read here, Mars Hill, talking about they were philosophizing as the Greeks do with Plato and whatnot. Read.
Now, while Saul waited for them at Athens, his spirit was stirred in him when he saw the city wholly given to adultery.
Therefore, just like you see running around here in your kind of way, read.
Therefore disputed he in the synagogue with the Jews and with the devout persons and in the market daily with them that met with him.
See, not just Jews at this point in time, because, hey, Saul was a Jew of all Jews, if you would, because he persecuted the Messiah, and he knew the law. He knew about Moses and this tabernacle and how to function in and out of this temple at his time, Saul I'm speaking of. He knew about this old covenant, this old law. He was steeped in that old idolatry of a law. That's what that all is now, is idolatry. Making idols out of these covenants that were set up for a certain people at a particular time. It don't even include you.
Right.
Nonetheless, keep reading.
Then certain philosophers of the Epicureans and of the Stoics encountered him and said.
Those are other nationalities besides just Jews. You see? Because, hey, Saul was converted in order to preach to the Gentiles. Because if he wasn't a Jew, every other nationality was a Gentile. And we're reading here, Mars Hill, he's talking to all of them. Because they all have the Holy Spirit in them. They just don't know, but they're trying to reason one with another. They're philosophizing, as it were. But keep reading.
What will this battler say? Others said, he seeth to be a sitter forth of strange deities.
That's what they're talking about, Saul. He's talking crazy. Mm-hmm. He don't be babbling. Because we're not up here speaking in tongues like you might read or hear some other organization speak in tongues. And they babble. They start shaking on the ground. We talked about it some today, right? And they flopping around and bodies is tweaking and jerking. That's all a game play.
Right.
That's all BS. That ain't going to save a soul.
That's right.
And therefore, we're coming down. We're speaking. I'm babbling. If you don't understand how these charts work, and I just told you, they ain't no more different than what's in your book. You just don't know how to read them.
Mm-hmm.
But then it's not babble. You can see words that you know about, letters. You see images, you see scriptures. Ain't nothing new. Mm-hmm. Just don't know what it looks like. Looks like scrambled eggs to me. Will said, hey, just know the story. Mm-hmm. We'll put it. The Holy Spirit will put it together in you because, hey, game recognize game is what we're talking about. Spirit recognizes spirit because spirit ain't gonna hang out with the flesh. With your carnal concepts is what we're expressing. If your opinions, your imaginations, your theories, that's not spirit. That's an illusion. And we're trying to erase the illusion for you to see the Holy Spirit working through every minute thing within the universe. To set you at ease, to set you at peace with you and your Creator. And be one with Him. Not separate. That makes you Yahweh. In flesh and blood on earth. and able to give life to somebody. By way of what? Of preaching and teaching the gospel. That's what it says in the book. They'll be saved by the foolishness of preaching the gospel. John's babbling over here. I'm babbling too. I'm preaching, but you know my words. You hear them, but don't you be concerned. Let that that's resonating, if it makes sense to you, come in and sup with you. That's what we want to get you to get to. But keep reading about John, this babbler, that they're Grecians and everybody's talking about John.
Because he preached unto them.
This is all we're doing. We might get loud. We might get our octave high sometime and get a low. And I'll try to stay cool. But see, he preached to them. He wasn't babbling. But keep reading.
And the resurrection.
He brought a babbling to them. Because he preached unto them Yahshua. Why? Because there's no other name given among men whereby mankind can be saved. Because why? Is Yahweh is salvation. This is what Yahshua means. If you understand the name, we're not just being stingy because you got to know the name. You got to understand that this is Yah is Yahweh. It's not another entity coming to save you. It is Yahweh himself. It's Yahshua. This is salvation coming unto you through my preaching of the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. Keep that on there, boss. Keep reading.
And they took him and brought him unto Areopagus, saying, may we know what this new doctrine is whereof thy speaking.
See, we speak a new doctrine here. We're not coming up here with no prescripted script. I'm not at home wondering, oh, my God, I got to write something for those people. Hey, I don't know you after the flesh. It's the Holy Spirit that know you. That's why there's no bond or no free, no little U's or big I's that I'm concerned about. Let them all come in. I don't care no more.
Right.
It don't make me no difference who I speak to because it's not me speaking after a certain point. I'll jaw-jack with you for a little bit, but eventually it's going to come out.
That's right.
It's going to come out. And I'm no longer going to be rearing it back no more neither. But keep reading about this doctrine that they ain't never heard. Because ain't no one heard the doctrine of Yahshua the Messiah. That's why they don't teach in the name of Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua. They're teaching Jesus Christ, God, and Lord. That's all they know. But they're not coming to you under the preaching in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. That they don't do. And when they say Yahshua, they're saying Yeshua. Not even understanding what the erroneous of Y-E-S-H-U-A even means. But that's another lecture. Yes. Keep reading.
But thou bringest certain strange things to our ears.
See, to your ears we bring in this strange thing. Keep reading.
We would know, therefore, what these things mean. For all the Athenians and strangers which were there.
See, the strangers and the Athenians, it ain't just Jews no more. We're not bellyaching with the Jews anymore and what this old covenant represented anymore. We use it, sure enough do, but we're not putting it on you. Everybody else, that's what makes this a strange doctrine. Mm. Hey, we ain't passing cups. We're not telling you to get dunked in water.
Right.
We ain't got no cups going around here collecting your money. We ain't doing none of that. But what we are telling you is that this has been passed and moved out of the way. And give me Jeremiah 31:31 in a minute. And so when you see that and realize that you've been set free or made free, made by understanding. It's not just set free, because some people say set free. You've been made to be free, made unto the gospel of Yahshua Messiah. That's what sets you free. You follow? There ain't no keypad or no lock that you're bound by nothing other than your conscience.
That's right.
You see, that's what that happened when Cain and Adam and Eve, appeared to have come out of this state and condition is according to their conscience. Adam was not deceived. He, in his conscience, he knew full well what Eve done did. But because of his love for his bride, he died the death of an outcast dog. And he came down and he walked Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh all the way down 4,000 years until he put himself on the cross. And he resurrected himself. Why? Because he's going to be the Savior of the whole world in the knowledge of who he is. Let the Spirit do what the Spirit is going to do. It will give you ascension within your soul, within your life. That's what the Spirit will do. We keep cock-blocking and messing with the Yahshua Messiah. Oh, man. We keep interrupting and getting in the way of Yahshua the Messiah is what I'm expressing. We keep having our opinion and saying, no, that won't work. Or, no, I don't have it in me. Or, I don't know what you're talking about. No, you do know. You do hear the simplicity of the gospel. Right. We get in our own way from achieving this that we can know and be free. Keep reading.
Spent their time in nothing else but either to tell or to hear some new thing.
That's what the whole world does. They looking for, searching for this. I was at the La Brea Tar Pits yesterday. I had to do this quick thing. I walk around the La Brea Tar Pits, and he got these two people inside a big wooden box that got a lot of dirt in it. And they're sitting there, and one's digging in the dirt, and the one's writing on the tablet, and they got, I don't know, hundreds of little vanilla envelopes. And I asked them, what are you guys doing? We're searching for fossils. And we're picking up seeds and bugs. And they're paleontologists digging through the dirt. I said, wow. You gotta do that all day? Said, yeah, all day. It's gonna take them 2 years to do this one box. They got over 100 boxes. And they're just chronologically put in an order everything that they find from wood chips. I said, how old? Oh, this is 40,000 years old. Oh, my God. I said, well, did you dig it up? Because we're building the construction right across the street. I said, well, did you get see, all that dirt that you come? We're just investigating, researching all of that dirt. I'm like, wow. Then I tell them about a site, a graveyard site. We found some bones at the graveyard site because when you touch bones up there or in certain places, you got to stop.
Oh, okay. Sacred.
Until they deem it. We done seen that before. Mm-hmm. Seashells on top of mountains, which gives you the understanding that the world was flooded at one particular time. It was once one great Pangaea, then it broken up. But that's another story. Mm-hmm. But again, it goes back to, they're researching everything. People are wanting to know about everything. And they file it away into the archives. It's what this Saul is expressing and talking to those people reading. Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Then Saul stood in the midst of Mars Hill and said.
Now he's in the midst of all them and it says this. Read.
Ye men of Athens, I perceive that in all things ye are devoted to the worship of idols.
See, he perceiving and understanding all that you're doing with all your research, and I perceive you just worshiping idols. That's all you're doing. Gloating on one another, expecting one another to do certain things, and just gloating. But what else?
For as I passed by and beheld your objects of worship.
The statues. And we have statues today that people worship and revere. Flags and everything else. Whatever you want to call it. Mm-hmm. They got it. Yeah. Read.
I found an altar with this inscription. Mm-hmm. To the unknown. Mm-hmm. Whom therefore ye ignorantly worship. Him declared I unto you.
Now he said, reread that again. Who's going to declare what?
I found an altar with this inscription to the unknown, whom therefore ye ignorantly worship, him declare I unto you.
Him declare I unto you. That's meaning Saul is the only one going to be able to declare that unknown God unto anybody. And this is why we take the stance and say, you ain't going to understand anything unless you come under the sounds of this gospel. There's no, because it's the Holy Spirit. It's not us.
That's right.
He can take me out of here anytime. But there will be another that's going to do his will.
That's right.
Just as Dr. Kenny came in doing his will. You just said the last thing he was told, man, what are you going to do with this that I've given you? Yahshua Messiah, the Holy Spirit, because Dr. Kenny say he didn't say nothing. He didn't know what to say.
Yep.
You read his biography about, Man, I was taken up to the third heaven, like Saul here is talking about. He was taken up there. He felt the children of Israel walking. He was sensitive to every jot and tittle that we're expressing to even learn about. That's what he experienced, you see. And when he said, I will teach your people, that's Yahshua's going to teach his people. Right. That we're not looking at any man. And don't let nobody tell you you worshiping any man named Dr. Kinley. Robert Harris, Marlon Love, it don't matter what the man's name is. You don't worship that. You worship the Holy Spirit, which is Yahshua the Messiah. See, you can know about Yahshua. You're not going to be able to perceive Yahweh because it's through the Son that you're going to be able to know the Father. That's the real Father's Day. You follow?
That's right.
My daddy told me once, why you call me father? The Messiah say, don't call no man father. And they call him the Pope father every day. They call him father. That's not your father. You want to be so sensitive and so sincere, so real. Well, get real with it. That's not your father. There's not but one father, and that is Yahweh. You follow? And that's what's going to set you free in the kingdom on earth. But keep reading here. With Saul,
Yahweh.
The unknown.
Yahweh who made the world and all things therein.
See, it's Yahweh who made the world and all things, including you, in, read.
Seeing that he is ruler of heaven and earth.
Seeing that he's ruler, not of heaven up there and the hell down there, in your consciousness of your thoughts, the earthly vessels. The world, he got good. He made it good and very good. But what's messed up? Is the egotistical, misdirected personality. People's opinion about who and what they think they are in the reality of things. But keep reading.
He dwelleth not in temples made with hands.
See, this is not a church. We ain't built this temple. And see, this temple back here, Yahshua would say he's going to tear it down and rear it up in 3 days. See, they don't realize, they won't realize he was speaking of himself within them. Not no physical temple. That's how literal people were taking him. That's why they didn't believe him. That's why they hung him out here on Golgotha. You follow? Because they're looking at him as this Mary and Joseph's little boy. They didn't realize Joseph didn't have nothing to do with Mary's conception. See, that was that of Gabriel, the archangel. You follow?
Right.
Coming from out of heaven down into the court roundabout to put that seed in Mary in the fulfillment of why, hey, why Yahweh took man out of Mother Earth. That's the pattern. That's how we can know and how we teach by law, prophet fulfillment, blood, water, spirit, 40, all the way through. That's with all these stories and even your story. Your life goes by. This is why it makes sense. Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Neither is worship with any man's hand.
See, we're not got no rosary. We ain't putting no charcoal on the forehead on Fridays, huh? No. Ash Wednesday.
Yeah.
We're not flying over to Mecca and trying to get into the area in Egypt in order to worship some box. Keep reading.
As though he needed anything.
As though Yahweh needed anything.
Seeing he giveth to all life and breath and all things.
I'd say we breathe the name of Yahweh. He give you life and give you breath. Psalms 150:6 makes it very clear. They let everything that have breath praise the name of Yahweh. But they're going to want to intimately change it to amen.
Yeah.
To get Yahshua or hallelujah and just say amen. Won't believe that that's a God that they use or pray to down here. Amon Ra. And they're amen and amen and amen. You just pray. You just saying the name of Amon Ra. Hallelujah to that. And then when they say hallelujah, you ask them how to spell it. They're going to put a J instead of a Y.
Right.
In your book, every book is going to have a J instead of a Y. The ignorance, the folly of it. That's what Eunice say. It's going to come a time you without excuse.
Right.
But keep reading.
And hath made a one man all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth.
And all the face of the world. So we're dealing with nations of people. We ain't dealing with Jews and Gentiles no more. Saul's already talking about we ain't neither Jew nor Gentile anymore. Mm-hmm. So we're coming to all the world, not just Americans all around the world of this one doctrine that ain't been heard yet. Keep reading.
And has determined the time before appointed and the bounds of their habitation.
See, Yahweh setting up the bounds, the beginning and the ending. As you come in screaming, Yah! And when you go out dying on your deathbed, way, he determined all of that.
That's right.
Not you. Don't care what you eat, vegan, vegan, what they call, just meat, paleo diet, whatever your diet is, it ain't going to make a difference, really. Do what you want to do. But you can be comfortable and eat well and not gorge yourself and be sick until your day comes. Because he'll set you up for many years and be sick and not be able to do anything and have any kind of joy or happiness.
Right.
If he don't show you what we're expressing. Keep reading.
That they should seek him, if happily they might feel
see,
after
you should
him.
Seek that unknown Yahweh. Even though you're walking and doing good, you should seek Yahweh. Mm-hmm. That's what he's telling them. Jew and Gentile, you should seek. It ain't just a God of the Jews. No, sir. They were peculiar people, and so are we, those who know the gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. Yep. We become peculiar people to a lot of people. Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
And find him, though he be not far from.
See, you can find him. Romans 1:19 and 20. That which may be known of Yahweh. Let's grab it and make it clear and make it right. See, Saul's just saying you can find Yahweh and know. He's not up in the atmosphere or way off yonder. We're not speaking off the some random expression, an idea, or an assumption. Mm-hmm. We're speaking by a pattern, and it's a heavenly pattern. And in read 19.
Because
go up to 18 first and catch Saul about what this is.
Where you want to pick it up at?
18.
For the wrath of Yahweh shall be revealed from heaven against all impiety.
No, go up one more. Go up again.
17th verse.
17.
Nope. 16. I want the gospel. For
okay.
I am not ashamed.
Yeah, there
16.
It is. 16.
I'm sorry. There we go.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of the Messiah.
See, he's not ashamed of the gospel because that's what's saving. I'm not doing anything. It's the gospel that's saving. And he's not ashamed of that gospel of Yahshua, the Messiah. Just to substitute that for Yahshua, the Messiah, if you like. Keep reading.
For it is the power of Yahweh unto salvation to everyone that believes.
So you have to believe it. It's the power of salvation if you believe it. You have to believe in this one, Yahshua, in order to be saved. Keep reading.
To the Jew first.
To the Jew first.
And also to the Greeks.
And also to the Greeks. That's your Jew. That's the Jews and Gentiles. That's why Yahweh is not a discerner. He's not a respecter of persons. So you can't just tell me, well, that's a God unto the Jews only. It don't fit. It don't work. Your so-called New Testament, the portion of your book, say it don't fit. It don't work. But keep reading.
For therein is the righteousness of Yahweh revealed from faith to faith.
See, I say from faith to faith. I said earlier. Mm-hmm. Eunice said earlier. It ain't faith to unbelief or unfaithful or blind faith. No, it's faith to faith. Faith is Yahshua the Messiah. Faith in the Holy Spirit. Not the man, the spirit that dwelt in the man. That's our faith. And it recognized faith when you speak the gospel one to another. That's how you reason. A person don't know this gospel, you can't reason with them. He said, where two or three are gathered together in my name. If they not believing in that name, you can't reason with that. Because Yahweh is not reasoning with a heathen, if you would. Mm-hmm. He's not reasoning with this that he's created. You are not reasoning with your little kid when you tell him to go do something. You're the creator. You have to set his way. You follow? But now more and more, you can't touch him. You can't do nothing. They'll call services on you, and now you're out of loss of control. And you whining about, I can't take care of my kid because I can't instill anything into him. Well, you just let him go rogue. That's your fault.
Yep.
You see, not the child's fault. Mm-hmm. He's just doing what he came out to do. Voila. Just like Eunice said, this old boy came out. He ain't nothing wrong with him. Ain't nothing wrong with evil that you see transpiring around the world. Mm-hmm. Nothing at all. Mm-hmm. Hard to be understood. Mm-hmm. But keep reading.
As it is written, the just shall live by faith.
See, the just, the right, is going to live by faith. And that faith is the knowledge of Yahshua. Keep reading.
For the wrath of Yahweh shall be revealed from heaven against all impiety and unrighteousness of men.
Oh, that's all talking about unrighteousness and not being met. But keep reading.
Who hold the truth in unrighteousness.
Hold the truth. You got a lot of preachers in wolf's clothing teaching the wrong doctrine, telling you this and that, assuming that they know it's important, but they just don't know. They just don't know. And they're taking your money, they're taking your wealth, and they're subjecting you under this old carnal covenant law, telling you, you shall not, having full control. You really mad at the government? The government ain't got nothing on what Yahweh got people delusional about. Because they don't seek Yahweh while he yet may be found. Keep reading.
Because that which may be known of Yahweh.
Now, there's something that can't be known. You can't tell me God's in heaven. I got to wait till I die and meet him at the pearly gates. That comment ain't going to work.
No, it ain't.
That's a lazy man's way out. But keep reading.
Because that which may be known of Yahweh is manifest in them.
There's something that's manifested in the individual. That's what Eunice was talking before she got off the floor. It's manifesting the gospel of Yahshua Messiah through her, where you're not dealing with a whole lot of nonsense anymore, as she once might have had. You see, that's that gospel changing the inner man, you see, into a righteous, just man according to the law of Yahweh. We're not talking about the law of Moses, but the law of the Holy Spirit, which dwelleth in every man that seeketh him. Keep reading.
For Yahweh hath showed it unto them.
He done showed it unto them. See, he showed it unto them first. And then on the day of Pentecost, June 6th, you see, early in the morning, 9 o'clock, that Holy Spirit came out into them. You see, they thought they was drunken men babbling and speaking in tongues. But that's not what the tongues they were speaking. They were speaking clear as day to those who had ears to hear and eyes to see. Keep reading.
For the invisible things of him creation.
These invisible things of Yahweh before the creation. You see, he created Elohim himself in shape and form that can be perceived. And then he created himself into a pattern. You see that everything was going to be coming out of that pattern, where it's going to have threefold manifestations. You see? 1, 2, 3. A, B, C. Water. H2O. You have the steam. You have liquid. You have gas or concrete or ice. Three states of liquid. Cell. Atoms, all set up in threes. Your fingers, your digits are set up in threes. Your hand, your forearm, your arm, upper arm, in threes. Everything got threes. You got 12 appendages around, witnessing to the 12 tribes of Jacob. You follow? And then the 12 apostles. But keep reading. Those are witnesses of what we can see that are invisible principles that we're taking and beholding them. You see, we're not bellyaching over who's who. We bellyaching over the principle of the spirit of life that has given us this, whereby we can compare and to reprove one another in truth, in righteousness, justly, rightly dividing the word of truth. All of these things come from out of the gospel. But keep reading.
For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen.
Oh, yes.
Being understood.
Got to understand it, though. When you understand it, what?
Being understood by the things that are made.
All things were made by him.
Even his eternal power.
Even that eternal meaning forever, power. What?
And supernal nature. So that they are without excuse.
So that you are without excuse. If you got anything out of today's class, all praises to Yahweh our Elohim by way of Yahshua Messiah. Let us all say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Dr. Marlon Lev. So this would conclude today's lecture. Are there any announcements? No. Okay. So let us stand to be dismissed. I'll be reading the doxology from the last two verses of Jude. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before